Welcome, students, to class number two. This will be a continuation of the New Testament canon, the information about the New Testament canon as we go into the lessons that will be in the future. This will be like our foundation so that we understand where did the New Testament and the Gospels, where did they come from? So question two, the New Testament canon, part two. So the testimony of Papias, Bishop of Hierapolis, about the New Testament. This is his testimony. First of all, understand that he lived in the years 70 to 150 years. That's during the time which he lived, from the year 70 to the year 150. So he was wanting to study the life of Christ in more detail. So what did he do? He met with those who themselves communicated with the apostles. Very smart. And what did he do? He wrote down their testimonies. So fragments of his five-volume book, Exposition of the Sayings of the Lord, have come down to us. Thank you, Lord. From it, we learned that the Apostle Matthew wrote his gospel in the Hebrew dialect, in Aramaic, and the evangelist Mark wrote his gospel based on the speeches of St. Peter, pronounced at different times, so there isn't any chronological order to it. Papias, that's the bishop of Hierapolis, also knows that First Epistle of Peter and First John and the Apocalypse, he knows about them. Interesting. During those early years, the other books were not mentioned in the fragments that have come down to us. But the appearance of various heresies, this is the second and third century, what began to happen was the appearance of various heresies. They forced the church fathers to make a list, a canon of New Testament books, so that heretics could not add fake writings to them and then refer to them. You get it? They make a fake writing and then you refer to it as an authoritative source. So that wasn't the right thing to do. Next, the Muratori canon. The Muratori canon is the oldest of the lists of the New Testament writings discovered by L. Muratori in the early 18th century. It's a second century manuscript. It describes the Gospels of Mark, the end part, Luke and John, and these numbered as the third and fourth in the order of the Gospels. Luke and John numbered as the third and fourth. It's obvious that the first in the list, in the beginning of the manuscript, was the Gospel of Matthew. The list includes all the books of the New Testament, with the exception of first and second epistles of Peter, the epistle to the Hebrews, and the epistle of James. In addition to this, the canon includes the Apocrypha, which is the Apocalypse, of Peter, and strangely, the Wisdom of Solomon. The following is a list of books that are not recognized as canonical. Not recognized. The Shepherd of Hermes, the Epistles of the Apostle Paul to the Laodiceans and Alexandrians, and a number of heretical writings. As I understand, there were many, many, many. So in the 4th century, Eusebius of Caesarea, like Origen in the 3rd century, divided the New Testament books into generally recognized controversial and false. So two categories, controversial and false. Among the first four Gospels, Acts of the Apostles, Pauline Epistles, and 1 John and 1 Peter, the Apocalypse. Among the disputed, but mostly accepted, were the epistles of James, Jude, and 2 Peter, 2 and 3 John. The fake ones include the Acts of Paul, the Shepherd, the Apocalypse of Peter, the Epistle of Barnabas, the teaching of the 12 apostles, Didache, and again the Apocalypse, which some people rejected and others did not, and also the Gospel of the Jews. So in the 4th century, the canon of the New Testament was practically formed, but among the churches of the East, Jerusalem, Syria, Egypt, the authenticity of the Apocalypse remained in question, and in the West, Rome, the message of the Apostle Paul to the Hebrews, mostly because the difference in the style of these texts from the other books of the Apostles, John and Paul. Thus, Cyril of Jerusalem considers 26 books canonical, except for the Apocalypse, according to the fourth catechumenical word. All right, and almost to the end, Saint Athanasius of Alexandria divided the Holy Scriptures into canonical, edifying, and heretical. In the 39th Epistle on Holidays, that's what it's called, he refers to the first 27 books of the modern New Testament and writes that no one would dare to add anything else to them. Among the edifying ones, he said, were the Shepherd, the Didache. So at the point at which the history of the formation of the New Testament canon was laid by the Council of Carthage was in the year 419, which approved all 27 books of the New Testament. So that's our class number two, just to lay a foundation with some background about the canon of the New Testament. Thank you for joining us. See you in the next class. God bless. Bye-bye.